To political science class, everyone. Okay, so we know that this is the second session for the chapter number one from the textbook Contemporary World Politics. Okay, the first chapter, it is the era of Cold War, and yesterday we completed the discussion on the Cold War and the reasons for Cold War, right? Okay, and we know that the contemporary era, that beginning or the starting from 1945, clear or not? Okay, almost we can say that it is era of the Cold War. The Cold War also started, okay, after the Second World War, clear? So Sneha, you missed the last two classes, right? Yesterday's. Okay, so please observe, watch the recorded classes of the same and learn the things properly, because continuation is necessary for this chapter. Okay, so yesterday's classes, it is your responsibility to do the same. Ashish Benny, well, you missed one class, right? Yesterday? No. You attended both. Ashish?
No, sir. No.
One class, right. Okay, so please observe that. Okay, please check it. Okay, so listen carefully, everyone. We discussed about the Cuban Missile Crisis yesterday, right? Okay, I hope the idea is clear for you. The topic is clear for you. I mean the Cuban Missile Crisis and how these countries tackled that situation or solved the problem of war. Okay, clear. So write down some points related with the Cuban Missile Crisis. It is important. The points, I mean the notes are important for us. Okay, so please write down the Cuban Missile Crisis. The Cuban Missile Crisis. Okay, so the countries involved in the Cuban Missile Crisis, what are they? Elvina?
America and Cuba.
Okay, these are the three countries. Okay, America, USSR. So that time it is not Russia, but Soviet Union. Okay, Soviet Union, clear. Okay, so try to use that term, Soviet Union. Okay, US, USSR and Cuba. These are the three countries. Okay, so we studied the name of three leaders also. Okay, Nikita Khrushchev from Russia, Fidel Castro from
Cuba,
correct. And from America,
John F. Kennedy.
Okay, so three leaders who involved in this that particular issue. Okay, clear or not? Okay, so it is Nikita Khrushchev from USSR, and who is that from Cuba? Fidel Castro, clear. And from America it is John F. Kennedy. Their rule is. So Cuba, you know that is a communist country. It is against the capitalist policy of America, and always they kept a close relationship with Russia. Okay, clear or not? So Russia also followed the communist, socialist or leftist ideology, clear or not? So Russia is in a dilemma related with the Cuba, okay, or administration in Cuba. They know that America is trying to invade Cuba and going to throw out Fidel Castro from power there, right? That time Cuba received a number of aids, help, I mean, in the terms of money, in the terms of weapons, they received a number of things from Russia. And finally, Russia used Cuba as a base for Russia to fight against America. And they planted or installed a number of nuclear weapons in Cuba. Okay. And almost all the major American cities came under the threat. Okay, of Russian missiles there. Okay, so John F. Kennedy is not ready to wage a war or fight a war against Russia, because both these countries' leaders know that both these countries are equipped with nuclear weapons there. So a war begin or war starts between these two countries, it will lead to a nuclear war. It is not that good for the entire world or the humanity, clear or not? So what John F. Kennedy did, he made a blockade around Cuba. Okay, naval blockade. He informed the American Navy to intercept the Russian ships, to reach the Cuban territory. Clear or not? Okay, so that crisis or that particular incident is termed as the Cuban Missile Crisis. Yes, you got that, right? How many of you watched the Safari Channel yesterday? Nobody. I told you people, right? Amal Raj. Do you observe any particular program there yesterday? No. Related with the Second World War? No one. No program. Okay, just check the schedule also. Okay, later. So, come back. Cuban Missile Crisis, write down. The Cold War referred to competitions. So, we know that it's a period of Cold War. It's arms race. Okay. It's not a hot war. It is not a shooting war. Okay. Clear or not? It's a Cold War. Okay. Referred to competitions. Tensions. And series of confrontations between the US and USSR backed by their respective allies. Keep the textbook with you. Any problem with the spelling, please check in your textbook. Later send the note to me. Yesterday only one student, only Aishwarya sent the notes. Others, no notes. What happened to you? What happened to others? No idea. They forgot or they are busy with some other activity. I don't know anyway. Please send that to me today itself. Okay. So are you facing any difficulty to write the notes? Anyway, you are writing that, right? I can see most of you guys are writing the notes there. Except one person. Okay. That person know that he or she is not writing the notes there. Okay, and I am not yet received any note from that particular individual. Okay, so I am not I am not going to say the name. I am not ready to humiliate or harass anyone. Not interested to that. You know that, right? So far, I am not personally harassed or humiliated any particular individual in this class or any class. I am not interested to that. Okay, so please. The thing that I am telling you people, it is so easy to do that. Anyway, you are writing the notes in the class itself. I am giving time for you people. Okay. So, simply listen in the class. Okay, politics is interest to listen. Okay. But what happened? After the class, you will forget everything there. Clear or not? That's what I am telling you people, to write the notes there. Okay, write the notes and keep with you. And refer it. And read the textbook also. Okay. So please send the notes to me. If you need problem with the data, tell me your number. I will recharge for you people. Okay. If you are saving data or something like that. Want that? Huh? I want to recharge everyone's number there. And tell the name of the service provider also. I will recharge for you people. So please do that. It is for your development. Clear or not? Please do that. Okay, I am happy to say that one or two students regularly, they will send the notes there. Okay, but yesterday I received only one note from Aishwarya. Others, no notes. No idea what happened to you people. Just do that, okay? So, come back. The Cold War, Ashish Bani, turn on your camera. The Cold War referred to competitions, tensions and a series of confrontations between US and USSR backed by their respective allies. Second point, Cuba was an ally of Soviet Union. Okay, an ally of USSR, and got both diplomatic and financial aid from it. And financial aid from it. Okay, what about diplomatic aid? I already told yesterday the story of the 1971's India-Pakistan war, right? Clear or not? So we received a diplomatic aid from Russia that time. Clear. So American Navy came to know that if they attack India, they want to face the Russian attack. Clear or not? Okay. It's a diplomatic aid basically. Okay. So America is against the Cuban leader or Cuban government, I mean, under the leadership of Fidel Castro. Okay, Fidel Castro, the famous communist leader of Cuba. Clear or not? Okay, that time Russia helped Cuba to resist or defend the American invasion. American invasion, that's what a diplomatic aid. Okay, and financially also Russia helped Cuba. Write down next one. Nikita Khrushchev, check the spelling in the textbook. Nikita Khrushchev, I am ready to say the spelling there, no problem. But you yourself, please check that in the textbook. Want to keep a strict and direct connection with your textbook. Okay. Nikita Khrushchev. Okay. So, come on. Nikita Khrushchev, the leader of the Soviet Union. The leader of the Soviet Union. The leader of Soviet Union decided to convert Cuba into a Russian base. In which year? Check your textbook and tell me which year. 1962. Okay, of course. 1962. Write down. 1962. He placed nuclear missiles in Cuba. Next point. The installation of these weapons put the US, for the first time, under fire from close range, and nearly doubled the number of cities in the American mainland, which could be threatened by the USSR. What is the full form of USSR? Full form of USSR? What is that? No idea. USSR. Union of?
Soviet Socialist Republics.
If you don't know, so please write down somewhere important. Union of Soviet Socialist Republics. Okay, group of countries. They believed in socialism. Okay, clear. So today, like that, groups are there. Heard about the UAE? Okay, what is the full form of UAE?
United Arab Emirates.
United Arab Emirates. United Arab Emirates. Number of Emirates are there. I mean, countries are there in that group. Any other groups are there? Cluster, cluster. Number of countries together doing economical and financial activities together. Administration is almost. How about European Union? European Union? In Europe. Number of countries, European countries are the part of the European Union. European Union. Clear? Okay. What is the currency of European Union? How about Euro? Euro? Okay, the common currency of them? Okay, let it be. So like that, USSR at that time. Okay, clear. Next one, next point. A clash seemed imminent. What came to be known as the Cuban Missile Crisis. The Cuban Missile Crisis. It made the whole world nervous. By creating clashes between the two superpowers. The US and the Soviet Union. Namely the Cold War. Okay. So it is not a hot war, it's not a shooting war, there is no bloodshed, it's a competition, tension, okay, between these two superpowers. Okay. Soviet Union and United States of America. United States of America. Why United States of America? It's a combination of number of states. Do you know what the name of American flag? Name of American flag? Flag of America. What is the name? Name is there for it. What is that? Stars and stripes. What is that? Stars and stripes. Clear? So if you observe the American flag, you can see number of stripes there, right? Number of lines are there. Number of stars are there. Count how many stars are there. That many states are there. Clear? Okay, tell me the answer.
Is it 58
stars? I don't know. Okay, check it. Okay, learn it. So I am giving this kind of work for you people to learn it. Just general knowledge things there. A student of political science want to know all these things there, right? Okay, so find it, learn it. Okay. Next one, the flag of Britain. Do you know? What is the name of the British flag? It is Union Jack. What is that? Union Jack. Okay. It's a combination of... Okay, find out the information. Okay, it's a combination of different flags. Okay, clear or not?
The Australian and the US flag.
No. It is Scotland, Wales. Huh? Isles are there in Britain, right? It's a combination of Scotland, Ireland, Wales, England. All these areas, they have their own flags. Okay. Later, Isles, they combined together, they joined together and created a new country called the United Kingdom, UK. United Kingdom. So all these flags combined together, Isles flags were combined together and they created a new flag. That is what the Union Jack. Okay, interesting stories are there behind. So what is the story of the name of Indian flag? Flag of India. What is that? Tell me first. No idea. Heard about Tiranga? Commonly we'll use the tricolor flag, right? Tiranga. Clear? Who designed the flag of India? Come on, fast. Who designed the flag of India? It is Pingali Vengaya. Pingali Vengaya. Again, it's from Andhra. Okay, let it. Okay, so find out the information related with that. So free time is there, means try to find out this kind of information. Avoid watching serials. Okay, serials in the 10 sense. How many of you watching serials there regularly? Serial lovers? No one? Malraj? No. Simply ask. Sneha? No serials. Elvina Joy? Yeah. Yes. Your face saying that. Okay. Grishma Joshi? No. No. Aishwarya? No. No, Jan. Not at all. Okay, let it be. Okay, fine. So, just try to find out this kind of information. So, internet is there with you. All informations are available. Just do that. Okay? So, that's what. I already told the three flags. That is the American one. And the India's. And Britain. UK. United Kingdom. Okay. So, next one. Write down. The Cold War in real terms. The Cold War in real terms. The Cold War in real terms. What is the Cold War? We have discussed. Okay, discussed from the textbook. Write down. In 1945, the Allied forces led by the US, Soviet Union. So we can say an irony here. Allied forces, who are there? Both these countries are there in the single group. Clear? US is there, Soviet Union also is there in the same group. Okay. Are they friends or enemies? Tell me. I only told you that at that time, the time of the Second World War, basically we are able to find, what is that? The world is divided into two power blocks. One block, democratic countries. Okay. Another block, dictatorial. Clear or not? So, US and the Soviet Union, they are democratic one. Okay. So, they joined together to fight against whom? Their common enemy. Who is that? Germany, Italy and Japan. Okay, Germany, Italy and Japan. Okay, clear or not? Okay, so US, Soviet Union, Britain and France defeated the Axis powers led by Germany, Italy and Japan, Japan, ending the Second World War in 1939 to 1945. Is that clear? Okay, so what are the power blocks that fought in the First World War? What are the names of those power blocks? Any idea? Homework for you. Find out the countries that fought or that participated. It's not an event for participation, okay. So basically participated in the First World War. Okay, it's a war, okay. Okay, come on. Next. Second point. Also in 1945, the Second World War ended and the Cold War began. Okay. Next. Continuation. When the US dropped bombs on Hiroshima, when the US dropped atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. In diplomatic manner, causing Japan to surrender. Ashish Benny, where are you, Ashish Benny? No answers from Ashish. Ashish, okay, causing Japan to surrender. Okay, please turn on your camera. Both the powers become reluctant to initiate war to protect world from large scale destruction as they were aware that it will not lead only political aim to them. Okay, engaging in the war with nuclear weapons not provide any political gain for these countries. It will destruct the world, right? Okay, so diplomatically both these countries stayed away from the nuclear war, or war, they're not engaged in the war. Okay, next point. Critics of the US decision to drop the bombs argued that the US knew that. So write US in capital letters. Okay, US. Finally, you will read that. The US argue that. It's not us, US. United States. Okay, write in capital letter. The US knew that. Japan was about to surrender. And that it was unnecessary to drop the bombs. Another question for you people. Name the inventor of atomic bomb. Do you know who invented atomic bomb? Find out. Tell me tomorrow. Okay. So we are discussing about this atomic bomb, dropping of atomic bomb, and how that made the changes in the world history, and how the Japan surrendered. So who invented that? That is the question. Right. Okay. So find it out and tell me tomorrow. So it's a science. Basically relativity physics. Okay. And chemistry. Right or not? Physics and chemistry. Clear? Yes or no? Both needed there for atomic reaction. You already studied in class 10 science there. Fission, fusion, like that. Right? Studied or not? Remembering that things there. So it's a great invention, but it is against the humanity. Clear or not? But today we are using this as what we can say for productive activities. Okay, nuclear power plants are there, right? Right or not? Nuclear power plants creating electricity, clear. But it is too destructive while using as a weapon or a bomb, nuclear bomb. Write down. So who invented it? Find out. That is not a question for our examination. So just understand that. That's what. Okay, clear. Anyway, so they suggest that the US action was intended to stop. They suggest that the US action was intended to stop the Soviet Union, intended to stop the Soviet Union from making military and political gains in Asia and elsewhere, and to show Moscow that, what is the importance of Moscow? So you can see in newspaper, New Delhi stated that, Islamabad stated that, Moscow stated that. What is the importance of Moscow?
Moscow is the capital of Russia.
Capital of Russia, good. USSR of that time. Capital. A capital city. New Delhi, capital of?
Yeah.
India, very good. Okay. Islamabad?
Pakistan?
Okay, fine. Okay, then write down. Moscow. That the United States was supreme. US supporters have argued that the dropping of atomic bombs was necessary to end the war quickly and to stop further loss of American and allied lives, and to stop further loss of American and allied lives. Okay, next point. Whatever the motives, The consequences of the end of the Second World War was was the rise of two new global powers on the global stage. Global stage, full stop. With the defeat of Germany and Japan, with the defeat of Germany and Japan, the devastation of Europe, and in many other parts of the world, the United States and the Soviet Union, became the greatest powers, in the world, with the ability of, with the ability to influence events, anywhere on the earth, Okay, so after the World War, two superpowers, right? That is USA and USSR, and they are capable to manage and control the events on the earth, it seems. Clear or not? Okay, that much powerful countries they are. Next point. While the Cold War was an outcome of the emergence, the US and the USSR, as two superpowers, rivals to each other, okay, comma, it was also rooted in the understanding that the destruction, caused by the use of atom bombs, is too costly for any country to bear. Okay, next point. The logic is simple yet powerful. When two rival powers are in possession of nuclear power, capable to create death and destruction. Death and destruction unacceptable to each other. Unacceptable to each other. Comma. A full-fledged war is unlikely therefore the backdrop of the end of the Second World War. The backdrop of the end of the Second World War led to the beginning of Cold War. Okay. Led to the beginning of the Cold War. Okay, now close your notes. Just open your textbook. Okay, so in the yesterday's class, hope this screen is visible for you people, right? Screen is visible? Right. Okay, so moving forward, so we completed and we are here, right? What is the Cold War? So now you know what is the Cold War, right? Okay, here the end of the Second World War was also the beginning of the Cold War. The World War ended when the United States dropped two atomic bombs on the Japanese cities of Hiroshima and Nagasaki in August 1945, causing Japan to surrender. Okay, clear? So in which year? 1945, the month of August. I already told you people yesterday. Okay. Critics of the US decision. So, number of people, historians, philosophers, scientists, they criticized the activity of America, US. Okay, why they criticized? So, critics of the US decision to drop the bombs have argued that US knew that Japan was about to surrender and that it was unnecessary to drop the bombs. Clear? The critic says, United States already know that Japan is going to surrender, then also they dropped the bombs. Why it is? Okay, for what it is? Their question. Okay, they suggest that the US action was intended to stop the Soviet Union from making military and political gains in Asia and elsewhere and to show Moscow that United States was supreme. So they stated that America dropped the two atom bombs in Japan. Okay. Already they knew that Japan is going to surrender. Then also they dropped it. It is just to show that what? America is powerful than Russia. Okay, or not Russia, USSR there. Okay, and making Russia to away from making political and other gain in the Asian continent. Clear or not? So America proved that they are able to, or they are capable to destruct the entire country. Clear or not? By dropping the atomic bombs. Okay. And give a message to Moscow that they are powerful than Moscow or the USSR. Okay, so US supporters have argued that the dropping of the atomic bomb was necessary to end the war quickly and to stop further loss of American and allied lives. Just now you wrote it. Clear? So the people, those who protecting or giving or they supporting the American action, they says that that was a good decision, what, dropping of atomic bombs. Okay, because of that drop, what happened? Japan surrendered and the war stopped. War ended. Clear. Okay, the consequences of the end of the Second World War were the rise of two new powers on the global stage. What are the two new powers? That is, what are they? After the Second World War, US and USSR. Okay, after the Second World War, the power distribution in the world, it is changed. Before that, it was Britain. Clear or not? So that time, we will say the time of the First World War, almost all the historians used to say that Britain's empire or the British empire, where sun never sets, that much powerful. Their colonies are almost all the continents. Clear or not? Clear or not? Almost all the countries are there under their control. But after the Second World War, the power distribution is changed. Two new superpowers emerged. They are US and USSR. Okay. The defeat of Germany and Japan, the devastation of the Europe and in many other parts of the world, the United States and the Soviet Union become the greatest powers in the world with the ability to influence events anywhere on the earth. Okay, so those countries become very powerful and emerged as two power blocks or superpowers and able to or capable to control the events anywhere on the earth there. Okay, clear or not? Okay, while the Cold War was an outcome of the emergence of the US and USSR as two superpowers rival to each other, and we know that they emerged as superpowers, but they are rivals. It was also rooted in the understanding that the destruction caused by the use of atom bombs is too costly for any country to bear. Okay, so, but they not used the atomic weapon against the other. Clear? For example, I can say one thing. Okay, already told you people, I think so. Okay. The power of the atomic bomb used by America in Japan, it is 15 Newton tons. 15, just 15. Okay. Okay. So just imagine one dot is 1 Newton. Okay. Clear or not? Newton ton, that's the power. So the bomb's power is this much only, this much only. Okay, just 15 Newton ton, that was the power of the bomb that used by America in Hiroshima. Clear or not? Okay, Nagasaki, it was 21. Okay, clear. Very powerful bomb. All of a sudden it killed nearly 75,000 people. Okay, clear or not? And nearly 1.5 lakh people become injured, became casualties. Clear. Now there is a bomb with Russia, termed as the Tsar Bomba. Its power is 50,000 Newton tons. So how many pages are needed to represent the power of the bomb with these dots? Can you imagine that? 50,000 dots I want to keep here. So can you imagine the power of that bomb? If it is dropped and it is blasted, what will happen? The entire humanity will face the consequences, right or not? Right or not? Okay, so they are not using those weapons against the other. Okay, both countries are able to use this kind of weapons there. So this is for our knowledge. Only we know that the power of that bomb. So more than powerful bombs with might there with China, there with America, there with Russia again. Even we people have in India, right or not? Nuclear weapons. Clear? These ideas are clear or not? Okay, next one. It was also rooted in the understanding that the destruction caused by the use of atom bombs is too costly for any country to bear. The logic is simple yet powerful when two rival powers are in the possession of nuclear weapons capable of inflicting death and destruction unacceptable to each other. Okay, they are able to do death and destruction, but they are not ready to do so. A full-fledged war is unlikely in a spirit or in spite of provocations. Neither side would want to risk war since no political gains would justify the destruction of their societies. Okay, so they are not ready to use these weapons because no political gain from the use of nuclear weapons is able to justify the use of nuclear weapons. Clear or not? Whatever may be the gain, but the use of these nuclear weapons is not going to justify their goal or justify their gains, I mean political gains. Okay, clear or not? Okay, hope these ideas are clear. Now we can see some pictures here. Okay, after the dropping of atomic bomb in where Nagasaki and Hiroshima, that what happened in Japan. Okay, so just observe it clearly. So it's the time to wind up the session now, and one more session is there today. Okay, so go for lunch and we will meet after the lunch. Okay guys, okay, thank you very much.